on Monday, so be aware of that. Ice Cream Social is on the 23rd. There's a sign-up sheet out there, and so please look that over. Also, there's no service on July 3rd. So July 10th is in the park. We have a worship service there, and we will figure out, I believe, during the ad board what we're going to be serving out there that day. So please invite. We are doing a discussion at the board meeting on a Mission Sunday for Redbird Mission is one that we support, and for a prayer walk. So we'll talk about that at the board meeting and come up with some other ideas of what we want to do with them. And Nordland Mission Fest is on Saturday, June 25th. And so I left, there's a yellow sheet of paper on the first round table out here. They're having meatballs and a bunch of other things, and then they have an auction too after that. So if you want to check it out, it's in on the table there. So, and I don't think is there anything more that I have missed this morning as announcements? No? Good. Well, then it's nice to have everybody here this morning. And I know I've already said that, but it's worth repeating. Okay? So as we begin this morning in our gathering, we have to really sometimes think outside the box. This first little clip here, I want to highlight something in there that most people don't preach about, but I think it's worth mentioning, okay? Does not wisdom cry out and understanding lift up her voice? She takes her stand on the top of the hill. I want to stop at that part. It caught my eye when it talks about wisdom and understanding. And wisdom and understanding in the scripture are described as she. We have the Father, we have the Son, we have the Holy Spirit. But this is the only one in the scripture that is described. Wisdom is a she. And understanding is a she. I think that is totally important for women to know. And also for men to know that there is a female representative all the way through the scripture. And it's wisdom and it's understanding. So God uses both men and women to proclaim his message. The only thing I thought about this also on a part was, we're women and we have wisdom, you know? And you kind of get that attitude. But if you have wisdom, you don't have arrogance. They don't fit together. But humility and wisdom fit together in peace. So it had caught my eye, and I thought it was well worth mentioning for understanding what God is doing. So beside the way where the paths meet, she cries out by the city gates, at the entry of the city, at the entrance of the doors, to you, O men, I call. To you, O daughters, I call. And my voice is to the sons and the daughters of men. Let us pray. O God, source of hope that does not disappoint, and love that fills our hearts, lead us through these present days. Give us the Holy Spirit to teach us endurance, strengthen our character, and lead us to you through Jesus Christ, whose grace enables us to stand. Amen. Please join in our new song, Rest for Your Soul.
Are you tired and troubled? Weighed down by heavy load? Praying for change, searching for faith, waiting on a miracle. Are you drowning in questions? Can't believe where the road has led. There's one who knows the heavy you hold, and he says, come to me, all who are weary and heavy burden, all who are hurting. Come to me, I'll be your shelter. My yoke is easy, my load is light, and you can find rest for your soul. Rest for your soul. There's a peace that can hold you, and a power greater than your own. When you feel so small, back to the wall, that's when Jesus calls. Come to me, one who knows the heavy you hold, and he says, come to me, oh.
Please join in the call to worship this morning. God, our Creator, is in this place. The God is with us. Jesus, our Redeemer, is in this place. The grace of our Lord Jesus. The Holy Spirit is in this place. The communion of the Spirit is with us. We welcome the fullness of God's presence. God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, be with us now and forever. Amen. I would like you to please turn in your hymnals to page 881, the Apostles' Creed. There is a little word in there that says the Catholic, and that is actually universal. That is a Christian church. Okay? So please join me on page 881. Most of us could start this by heart, but 881. Say it as if you mean it, with your whole heart. Put all of you into this statement. It is a creed that we are actually proclaiming before God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead and ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please join while you're up. The words of assurance, the word of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are faithful forever. Please join in the Gloria Patri. This morning, our message is from John 16, but actually I'm going to back up one and do part of John 15, because we need to know what Christ said to his disciples, because it is so important for us to know those words. So in John 15, I'm starting at verse 18, and I'm actually reading from the New King James Bible, not from the Pew Bible. Listen closely to what not only does he tell his disciples, he is telling us this morning these very same words. If the world hates you, know that it hated me before you. If you were of the world would love its own. Yet because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will keep your word also. But in all these things, they will do to you for my name's sake, because they do not know him who sent me. If I had come and spoken to them, they would have no sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. He who hates me hates my Father also. If I had not done among them the works which no one else did, they would have no sin. But now they have seen and also hated both me and my Father. But this happened that the word might be fulfilled, which is written in the law. They hated me without cause. And we start. But he tells us there's more to it than worrying about the world hating us. He has someone that will come alongside. But when the Helper comes, the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whatever name, the Holy Ghost, whatever name you want to put on to him, but that's it. But when he comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, and the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father. He will testify of me, and you will bear witness, because you have been with me from the beginning. As we look at that alone, Christ and the Father did not want us to be alone in this world. He wanted someone that would come and live within us. And last week, we had celebrated the coming of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit lives within us. And the statement that he makes here, he has been in you all this time, since the beginning. How do we know that the Holy Spirit has been in us since the beginning? Because God knew before we even took a breath who we were going to be. He knew that. And he knew if we were going to follow after the Lord Jesus Christ, we would need help within us, because we did not have enough power to choose Jesus Christ on our own. Not an ounce. He says he's already been there with you. So those that are called by the name of Christ, since you were born, you were already pre-chosen by Christ to follow him. The one thing our patient, loving, kind, and generous God does, he gives you a chance to say, no, I don't want any of it. But it doesn't mean that he gives us up on us either. Because there are times when we will bend again and come back and serve the Lord over and over. He tells them. He's pouring out his heart to them. Jesus Christ is. His love to them and to us. These things I have spoken to you, that you should not be made to stumble. Know that there are things that are coming down the pike for us. Know, when it was in my generation, I never heard of churches where people went in and shot the parishioners. Never heard of it. We are in a time when the world challenges everything we believe and everything we think. And he says, I do not want you to stumble. I want you to know that this is coming, and be prepared. Set your heart upon me and upon the Father and upon the Holy Spirit always. That's where your salvation is. That's where my salvation is. Even if they take our lives, we still have salvation in Jesus Christ. We will not have died in vain, because we will have died because we love the Father and we love the Son. And he wants us to know that. These are his words that he speaks to us this day. They will put you out of the synagogues. There's no maybe here. They will put you out of the synagogues. Yes, the time is coming that whoever kills you will think that the offers God service, that they're doing a service for the Lord God. And these things they will do to you, because they have not known the Father nor me. But these things I have told you, that when the time comes, you may remember that I told you of them. And these things I did not say to you at the beginning, because I was with you then. He goes on to proclaim the message of the Holy Spirit, of what he did. And when the Holy Spirit comes, where are you going, was the questions. But I am now going, and no, I'm going to leave, and nobody asked me where I'm going. But because I said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. It's not an easy message to hear. In fact, it's hard to think about it, that we sit here because we love the Lord Jesus Christ, and we want the rest of the world to love the Lord Jesus Christ. We want our friends and our family to know the Lord Jesus Christ and love him. And he's saying here, they might be the ones that are sending you out from your churches and your synagogues. And he says, I'm going. And they don't even ask him where he's going. Where are you going, finally? But because I said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Holy Spirit will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. He did not leave us alone. He sent someone that would live within us. We have to turn our ears and our heart and our soul to be able to hear him and shut out the clamor of the world, because he doesn't holler at us like the world does. Sometimes he should, because sometimes we're really deaf. And even if he repeats over and over again, we just can't say, yeah, tomorrow I'll do that. But he's still within us. We know that there is a voice that comes in there that sometimes doesn't make sense, but we know it's not ours. We know that the Holy Spirit is there. And what does the Holy Spirit do? What good is he for living within us? There's a list, actually, that Jesus gives us, that gave his disciples. He will convict the world of sin. He will tell them of righteousness, but he will also tell them of the judgment of sin. What lies at the gate, at hell's gate? He will tell them that judgment is coming because they do not believe in righteousness. That is hard for us to even think about. But look at the world. Do they believe in righteousness? Do they believe in holiness? Do they believe even in right or law? Or is it the generation that it's all about me and what I want? I don't care what anybody else wants. They don't believe in righteousness. And if you don't believe in righteousness, you're not worried about judgment either. You're not worried about sin either. But there is a price that will be paid for ignoring it, because they do not believe. I still have things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. Which means there's more coming. More that he will reveal, that we need to know. And he will reveal it to us. The Holy Spirit will walk us through this. Jesus is not just leaving the world and leaving us alone. He has given us the Holy Spirit to guide us and to teach us. When the Spirit comes, he comes with truth. Listen to these. The Holy Spirit will guide you into all truth. A simple question to the Holy Spirit is, Holy Spirit, show me the truth. Teach me the truth. That's what I want to know. That's what I want to count on, is the truth. Not speculation, but show me the truth. Open the scriptures to me, that I might read and see for myself the truth that you are telling me. For he will not speak on his own at all, but he will speak whatever he hears from the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. One of the things that we are fall short on is we don't ask the Holy Spirit for information. we don't take the time to sit with him and say, I do not understand. I need you to show me. And I found out the one thing I'm probably the worst about of my own self is doubting. Doubting and being a Christian is really very difficult because you're always to one side or the other. You never know where truth really stands. And that's the doubt. The truth stands there, but do we believe it? Do we truly believe it? That's where we need to stand. If God's word says it, I believe it. I'm not going to doubt it. Because that's the only place we can really stand, is truly on God's word. And we have to stop scratching our heads that goes, maybe. No, it's truth. The truth that Christ died for us, he shed his blood for us. It's truth that the Holy Spirit lives within us. It's truth that we know the Father and we have a right to call him Daddy if we want. That's truth. The truth is that the body of Christ is sitting here. So the Holy Spirit is very effective in this place because it's in each one of you. Jesus Christ is very effective in this place because he's in each one of you and the Father looks over us. He has a lot to say to us. There's a lot coming down and a lot going on. But we stand on the truth with the Lord God. The Holy Spirit will also, his job is to glorify Jesus Christ. The only reason that we actually came to be Christians is because the Holy Spirit brought us before the Lord Jesus Christ and showed us our need of him and our desire of him and our want of him. That was the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit that reminds us of those little things in our lives that drive us crazy that we don't want to do, but we do anyway. But we can take that before the Holy Spirit and say, Lord, please remove this sin from my life. I want to be holy and I want to be righteous. The Holy Spirit has many things that he does, but he takes the word of Christ and he declares it to you in your heart. There are times when scripture will come, and that is the Holy Spirit declaring it to you. If we start out, or I start out with the 23rd Psalm, most of you could say it without even looking at it. It has now become part of you. You just know it. The Lord's Prayer is now part of you. Words from Christ, they are in you. They're all there to build you up and hold you. He will declare it to you. All that the Father has, all that my Father Jesus is saying, all that the Father has, everything the Father has is mine also. It is mine. And the day that he went to the cross and he said, Lord, he told his Father, I have kept them all. Each one that you have given me, I have kept for you because you have given them to me except for the one, the son of perdition. I could not, he would not surrender unto me or unto you, the Father. But we are all his. Everything that we listen for in him, we are all his. For this reason, I say to you that I will take what is mine and declare it to you. We have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, a personal one, that he waits every day to hear our voice. The joy that the Father feels when we call upon his name, he knows our thoughts before we even think them. He knows us personally. And the amazing thing is, the greatest thing in this universe, in this world, wherever you are, there are three things. And they're all dedicated to you and to me. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are dedicated to us, that we be dedicated to Him and live as we are the children of the King of Glory, that we are brothers and sisters with Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, and that we have the Holy Spirit meeting with our spirit to be one in the Lord God. He pours out His blessings every day upon us, whether we recognize them or not. Tomorrow, this morning, it is a blessing for you to be here in this place and for me. But it also is a blessing to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jesus has much to teach us and much to tell us. The Holy Spirit comes along and deciphers for us truth and the anointing, and they all celebrate as one. Let us rejoice in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, it is hard for us to sometimes imagine this, to even kind of comprehend it, that Your love is poured out on us. We know who we are. We know the words that come out of our mouths, and we know the thoughts that are in our minds also. And sometimes, Lord, they are far from righteous. But we thank You, Holy Spirit, for calling us back to bend our knees before You and confess our sin to You. And we thank You, Holy Spirit, for the reminder of where our truth lies and where our joy and our celebration lies. It lies in the all-powerful, mighty One God, that are three. This morning, for Trinity Sunday, the one God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, all together, one and in perfect harmony, we celebrate them. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Please turn in your hymnals to Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Do you know why there's three holies there? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Be seated. Our joys and concerns this morning, last week, I know I missed the tablet and the paper and all, so, okay. Is there any other prayers that didn't make it to the paper for our joys and concerns and praises? And I will tell you this morning, and I should have done it at the beginning, the roses up here. We'll pray for Pat and her family this day are in honor of Paula. Today is also still is Paula's birthday, and also the day that she went to be with the Lord. So please, let us pray now. Heavenly Father, we thank you for and celebrate the life of Paula this morning. She has been dearly missed by all, O Lord. But there in heaven, I'm sure, she has a special place. But we remember her and honor her. And we thank you for the gift that you gave unto us with her. Be with her family and strengthen them, O Lord, this day. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Pat has one. Roxy Anderson has lung cancer. She is down in Atlanta, Georgia, and we have prayed for her before. Pat got to go down to see her, and so I will lift her before you. And she watches by Facebook. So, and we thank you, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you continue your healing process with Roxy. We ask your presence will be with her right now, wherever she is at, that she will feel the joy of you and the peace of you and the loving kindness and the touch of Jesus Christ upon her as her body continues to heal and her spirit sings and rejoices in knowing you, the Lord Jesus Christ. For that we thank you, O Lord. We have Barry Weber. John's brother-in-law's father. Okay. Who has passed away. And we pray for the prayer. We have prayers. And we will pray for them. Heavenly Father, as this family walks through the valley of the shadow of death, be with them this day, O Lord. Comfort. Guide them beyond here, O Lord. Send those around that will comfort them, that will bring them peace, but will bring them total comfort. We pray for you, the Lord Jesus Christ, to be there with him. And we know you are, because your word always tells us that. Strengthen them and grant them courage in your blessed name, O Lord. We also pray for Jim Ahrens. Jim Ahrens is a great uncle to both Luke and Jean. And he has passed away. And Jim Ahrens, I knew him a long, long time ago when I was in high school. I used to go to their house and visit with him. A very gentle man, a very good man, a very loving man. So him and his family are together. So that'd be Dan's brother. So let us pray for them. Heavenly Father, as they come together to mourn their loss, O Lord, surround them with your presence, O Lord. Watch over them and keep them as they celebrate. It is hard to do, to celebrate and mourn at the same time, but Jim's life was a celebration and is a celebration, and he leaves much behind in celebration. And we thank you, O Lord, for being their strength and their counsel. In your name we pray. Amen. Anything else this morning?
Now we're praying for rain because we really do need some. And I thought, God, why are we not praising you and thanking you for the green, the beautiful, what we have, instead of we come out with complaints more than we do all the positives that we have?
Very true. It's more easier to complain than it is to praise. It's kind of that nature that is in us. We really fight that. So rely upon the Holy Spirit for the praise in there. So anything else this morning? Happy birthday to you. Anything else this morning that we want brought up? Okay. We are going to take a moment this morning of silent prayer. We did not have a prayer of confession this morning because we had the Apostles' Creed that was promising. But we're going to take a moment here and silently, as the body of Christ, as agreeing with one another, as we lift our prayers together before the throne of grace. Oh Lord, you hear every prayer that has been said. Lord, we do pray for revival across this land. We do pray that it will go across in a wave from one end to the other, because America has been a country that has taken missionaries and has taken Bibles and has taken the Word of God out across the whole world. Lord, there are many, many here that are holy and righteous, O Lord. But we are losing them to the enemy and to the world. Lord, please help us bring revival to this land that will awaken the hearts of the people again, that this is who we want to serve, is the Lord God Almighty, not the devil, not the enemy. We want to serve Christ. So, Lord, I ask that if you, we ask, not just me, millions across this nation are asking that revival come across and through America, to set us on fire again for you, to also bend our knees to what the forefathers thought that this land was to be, one nation under God. Revive us again, O Lord, for your glory, for your honor, and for your praise, that righteousness will again be spoken of in this land, and bind the hands of the enemy. For this, O Lord, we seek you. And now, O Lord, if you have taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Is there anyone that would like to be anointed with oil this morning? Okay. At this time, we will receive our gifts and our offerings. Oh, Father, your gifts come in so many ways. The gift of us being here this morning, of being able to worship into your presence, oh Lord, what an amazing gift. We give back to you, Lord, our hearts and our lives. Please use them mightily for you as you use this offering also, Lord. And we still, and I still, oh Lord, would ask that you will use it mightily here in this time, in this place, maybe a tent, O Lord, for this congregation. For we thank you, O Lord, in your precious name we pray. Amen. Thanks, Brian. Just a little something I wanted to upper room this morning was, sometimes I doubt that God cares about the mundane aspects of my life, right? Yet, at the same time, how I handle the mundane things reveals my character. After all, Jesus commends those who are faithful with small things. So, how true that really is. Please join in our song. Come, thou almighty King. didn't ask you this morning if there's anybody that has a testimony of what God has been doing in their life this week. Okay. The Lord gave me a word yesterday out of Chronicles. Yeah. So I am deciphering. So pray for me that the Lord will finish it and will give me greater understanding and wisdom in what it really means that he lays the plan before me, because sometimes I'm really confused. So, okay, thank you. Go in the grace and the peace and the love of the Lord Jesus Christ, knowing that the three most powerful things in this universe love you fully and completely. Go in him and celebrate a life he already has for you. For this we rejoice. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Hallelujah and amen. God bless.
Are you tired and troubled, weighed down by a heavy load, praying for change, searching for faith, waiting on a miracle? Are you drowning in questions, can't believe where the road has led? There's one who knows the heavy you hold, and he says, come to me. All who are weak.